apparently. Look at this. The place is wild as the Coyotes welcome the Mighty Ducks. A first ever playoff game in this arena. They're standing and cheering and have been for a long time. You can't beat this with excitement.
The first ever playoff game here in Phoenix, and the crowd is ready for this hockey. It is going to be a great, great atmosphere earlier in this game.
Isn't this wonderful?
Get the crowd out of it.
Well, a lot of teams in the National Hockey League have asked their fans to come dressed in white over the years, or red if you're a Calgary Flames fan. This was the scene in Winnipeg when they were eliminated by Detroit a year ago. Now the franchise has moved to Phoenix, and they have taken care of your boys. This was on the ice at the Winnipeg Arena for their final game, and now live in Phoenix. They've continued this tradition, carried over with the newspaper support and the endorsement of the hockey team. I'm dressed in white.
And 15,000 white t-shirts before this game to make sure everybody was in white.
There, as you saw by Cliff Wadding, he's number 77 for the Coyotes. Jason Moore has knocked it over the line. Trevor had a stick on it, lost it, and Wadding finds the score!
Shannon cutting to the net has given the Coyotes the lead.
Number 77, Cliff Ronning. He faked the shot, and what he did, Shannon was driving towards the net. You see right here, the beautiful pass through. Defenseman is on him, but Shannon, good strength, just tips it. And this crowd gets exactly what they wanted, an early goal, and they are now feeling the effects of all of this white in this building.
Boy, they can feed off that. Now the Coyotes are away. Dropped it back. Horkum kept one in front that was blocked and knocked away from Wadding. Up the slot, about to score! Darren Quinn got it underway.
The breaks that Phoenix were not getting games one and two are starting to get in tonight's game.
There's a discussion going on. They've gone upstairs for a review, but here's what was seen from overhead. Referee coming into your picture, pointing to the shooter and saying, yep, it's a good goal, but now it's under review.
The goal is under review.
Is his foot in? Oh, it jigs.
Wow. Oh, boy.
Now, Phoenix has had goals called back in each of the first two games. Is it, you're pregnant or you're not pregnant? No, no in-between line in this situation.
So there's Don Hay, the Phoenix coach. His team up 2-0 now as that goal comes at the 8:50 mark of the opening period. Good tempo, isn't it? Right there, lost control of the puck, and Kachuk sets up running for a drive. He scores!
Ronan, but some of those secondary players for Phoenix have come up huge in the first period. Ronan and Shannon. Shannon with a couple of goals. Phoenix right now, they're getting some breaks. They're skating well. They need to be stopped. There's.
Ah, it's nice to be creative. On the draw for the Mighty Ducks. But here not to Daniel. Up the slot for the drive to change direction, and Correa scores! Got his own rebound and puts it upstairs. 3-1 hockey game.
This is a perfect example of the brilliance of Paul Correa.
Well, he's back to clear it to the near side. Anticipated, or at least Newman did, a whistle, I believe. And Correa fires, all just missed.
You know,
loosen up. But right there, Park, who's got great speed, we talked about, makes a nice play, and you saw what Kareem did. He waits and waits. He waits so well for the opening and just missed top shelf left side.
Got a little look. Yeah, this'll do it. That'll get you on TV. This is... Bobby Gulick thought about covering it. Ryan Bellows is able to move it to John Proctor. Set it all. What a stop by Bobby Gulick. Man, oh man, Joe Sacco has just looked to the ceiling in this building and said, why me?
And also the fact that Anaheim has played great hockey at home, and they're going to be very, very difficult to beat in the pond. So they can't afford to lose a game here. I don't think they can win two games in the pond.
Now let's bring them in to Craig Gaddy. Gaddy for Phoenix. The great put it in front of a nice deflection and then off the top of the net.
Well, Hubert has righted himself from after allowing three goals in the first period and been solid here in the second. There's two ways to look at this. Phoenix hasn't put the Anaheim Ducks away. But on the other side, they haven't made any key mistakes that have allowed Anaheim to make this a one-goal game. Kachuk, who doesn't seem to be feeling any ill effects of that thumb that he got whacked earlier in this period. Now, Drake has been, with the Dronich being put on Korea to check, Drake has been put on this line with Janney and Kachuk, and he's had a very good game.
Jigsy, it's a different period in playoff hockey than it is during the regular season. You are now concerned only with shutting down the other team. There are no, I need a goal, I need an assist, I need any personal stats.
No.
You don't look at the score sheet after the game. There's a W or an L, and that is it. There is so much energy in this building. The fans that came in with the Anaheim Ducks uniforms, I was out in the corridor, and I heard booing. I thought the Anaheim Ducks were coming on the ice. It was just a few fans with Anaheim Duck jerseys on who were walking down to their seats.
Yeah, you're not going to be able to sneak in here. Any sign of a support for the Mighty Ducks. But today's game for the Coyotes, 0 for 5 thus far. Seal Blake goes to work. Play goal here, and you've got Anaheim down by three. Hey, I think he may have competed. Ray was with us last night. I'm not sure which. We're trying to go for dinner with Paul Kariya. See if we couldn't make an order, you know, a side dish of peas.
Uh-huh.
Couldn't find Paul.
They really did get into it, didn't they, the fans?
Oh, did they ever.
I mean, there was 2,000 people here at about 10:30 outside trying to get in, all in white. Everyone, it's a nice day, so a lot of people have the white shorts, and they were great promotion. The fans really took to it.
Win here gets them back into it. You gotta win the first before you can win the second. A 2-on-1 break. They score!
Final score, 4-1.